Here goes chapter 3. So we slept last night on two benches like a couple of homeless people. Until I figure out exactly what's going on today, take these next 30 to 60 seconds of video to just watch without context.
Now we receive. I'm gonna come with audio on that.
I knew that when I told myself that this trip wasn't going to go how I thought it was going to go, I had the idea of what uncertainty was like because of my past and understanding how things don't normally play out and how I think they're going to go, but this trip is way different than anything I've ever experienced. Let me just to say here at this point, for those of you who are watching, let me explain what's about to happen. I am currently in Estación de Cartama, Spain. It's just north of Malaga. Here is where I will be hosted for the next week while my leg rehabilitates. I've gone from barely being able to walk to being able to cycle, and actually, in fact, yesterday I cycled 57 miles, but it still hurts and it still needs to heal. Nathan has gone off to do his own thing while I'm here. He's gonna continue cycling. But as far as the video goes, well, today is day 15, I think. And where it picks up next, I'm not sure. For my friends and family, know that in this moment, I really, really miss you guys. Still have a lot of stuff to do. So, I'm curious to see where we pick up.
As you can clearly see behind me, I am on a mountain. But not any mountain. This is Mulhacén, the tallest mountain in Western Europe and the third most prominent peak in the entire continent. It's 11,440 feet. And a lot has happened since we saw each other last. My leg has healed up completely, as you can tell, because I wouldn't be able to be up here if it wasn't. I've spent 9 days in the Malaga area, Nathan and I have met back together, and we are going to take a train together to Valencia and continue cycling from there. Man, guys, I wish you could be here with me right now. This is absolutely amazing. This is why I photograph. This is why I make videos like this. And this is the stuff I want to share with you guys. Thank you so much for watching this stuff with me and being a part of my life. So, today is not already off to a good start. We got here to the train station to take a train to Valencia, and we got stopped immediately and told we couldn't go on the train because our bikes had to be put away in a luggage compartment, that we need to disassemble them, put them in a bag. But because of that, we were forced to miss our train. We bought the cheapest tickets possible, which are ones that are essentially non-refundable. Because of that, that causes a few issues there. We went to the guest services desk and they said it's possible that we could exchange them for tomorrow, but if not, we have to purchase a train ticket for tomorrow and then hopefully be able to get these ones refunded. Either way, this sucks right now. What do you think?
You know what I'm gonna say. It is what it is.
So some time has passed, and Nate and I have gone through a lot trying to figure out what to do, and they refunded our tickets. And these tickets, like I said, were supposed to be not refundable, but they worked with us. They felt our pain. Thanks to my mom, who I had to wake up at 3 in the morning because, I don't know,
they heard my pitiful Spanish, and they had pity on me.
Yeah, they realized we were just white trash Americans, and we didn't know what we were doing.
Basically.
my mom said, why don't you rent a car? I'm like, oh, wow, didn't even think about that. So, Nate and I are going to head over to the car rental agency right over here in this train station and see if we can rent a car, essentially, and it would actually be cheaper than even the train that we were originally going to go on. So, we'll see what happens. After the most stressful 3 hours of our trip. Well, probably there's been more stressful times.
I had a stressful time back when we were separated.
We got our car. Volkswagen Polo. Nate's trying to figure out how to open the trunk. He's struggling. Nate, you just pop the hood. See, the thing is, Nate comes from a farm, right? So he doesn't actually know how to do this and like lift up. But I won't tell him that, so. What?
How'd you do that?
Go ahead, try it.
How'd you do that?
I don't know, figure it out. See, you didn't. As this cross-continental cycling journey turns into a frantic, senseless expedition, we're going to make this 6.5 hour drive to Valencia, about almost 400 miles. We're just gonna take our time, we don't have to return the car for 24 hours, but it's the unexpected, man. Nope. Dude, how are you feeling about this?
I'm wishing I was driving.
Oh. No.
This is like the nicest car I've ever been in, almost.
Yeah, look at those revs, bro. Look at that.
Baby.
All right, so we're gonna get on the road.
Yeah, we're going.
Thank you.
But we made it to Valencia safely, and right now we are going to try to figure out exactly where to stay tonight. We're going to do some research because we don't know yet, and it's like 9 p.m., so...
Quarter after 9.
Yeah. Nathan and I are on the way right now to a campsite, and it's 10 p.m., and we're trying to figure out if they're even open, and we're just going to go there, wing it, see what happens. If not, all the hostels are sold out, and we just want to go to sleep.
We might sleep on a bench again.
In the rain? Yeah. It's raining as well. It is also raining. We actually arrived at the campsite, and they said that they had room. So we're going to set up a tent like that. Wait, like that. There's a tent. We were surprised that we got it, but you know the Lord provides, right? And morning it is. Nate, how does that yogurt taste? Tastes like victory? Because it shouldn't. It should taste like yogurt. But we have breakfast, and we are in Valencia, Spain. And of course, unfortunately, we had to take a car here, which was never in the plan, but gotta plan for the uncertain, right? But we're basically right back on track now. We are about two or three days out of Barcelona. And after Barcelona, we're gonna head right up to Andorra. But meanwhile, we're gonna explore the city of Valencia today. See what the city has to offer. I heard the oranges are pretty good here. So, let's get to it. The guy just gave us free beers, essentially, and he said in order for me to get it, I had to chug one, and it's a sweet cup, but the beer actually just tastes like it's crap beer, so trust me, kids, it was worth it for the cup. So we say goodnight to Valencia, good day, good simple day.
Today is another day in Spain. Valencia is quite beautiful. However, today is the day that we leave. And today we're gonna go to Villarreal, Spain. It's about a 40-mile cycling ride. And we have a couch surfer waiting for us today. So, let's get on the road. When you listen to Google and trust it for the bike paths. Yep. We're gonna stop in here and get some kebab. It's so far. Finally arrived at the town of Villarreal. And Nate, are you happy, bro?
I'm all happy.
Jamie Bond, these kids over here are like smoking pot and stuff like that. So just gonna ignore them for now. But we're waiting on our couch surfer.
And we have made it to our couch surfer zone. It's about 9 p.m. So let's go see everyone.
By everyone, I mean Nate.
Oh, hi.
And Jordy. Here's our couch surfer. Say hello, Jordy.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Here's the kitchen that we're about to make dinner in. And here's Nate's tan line.
Yeah, I know. Look at that.
I realized my face and how sunburned everything is. And that's crazy, you guys. That's from the hike. So, I don't know what to do. I look like I have leprosy or something.
Making some potato omelets. Frittata looks muy bueno.
We got some more meat and bread and a bottle of wine that we're gonna crack open.
And John's about ready to fall asleep.
Whew. Let's get on the day 29. Dude, what'd you think of that food?
Dude, that was like the best food.
That was like the closest thing to an American meal I've had since I've been here. Thank you. Thank you.
It was great.
Thank you. We're ready to go.
Here we go.
These are the moments where Google knows what she's doing. Slight mishap, problem, whatever you want to call it. Last week, Nathan had a spoke come loose, and so he had it fixed at a bike shop, but now apparently another one has come loose.
Well, it's just straight up broken.
Well, yeah. For now, Nathan is just gonna ride and pray that nothing goes wrong. We still have 11 miles to get to the town. I kind of told Nate that we should hitchhike to the town, or that he should put the bike in the back of a truck, but we'll see what happens.
Just took my bike into the shop. It'll take about a half hour, 12 euros to fix it.
But we found it. Yeah.
We found it. Took a little bit to find it.
Took a little bit to find somewhere on this map here, but we got it.
It's stressful.
But hey, we made it to the town safely. High five. All right, Nate's getting on his bike for the first time since the spoke got replaced. We don't really know what we're doing yet tonight. So after actually cycling for quite a bit, we came to this campsite here. Went inside the camp office, walked right up to the desk, and asked them, do you have a camping spot tonight for two people, no car, and a tent? And they're like,
we have one spot left, and it's 26 euros.
Yeah, 26 euros. And Nate walked in at that moment, and he's like,
wow, that's expensive.
Now we're just standing out here thinking like, okay, what do we do? And we're like, wait a second. The whole idea in the first place was to just throw a tent down aimlessly, no matter where it was, and just go for it. So we're gonna get back on the gravel road that goes into this mountain range way back here. It's like 10 miles to the next town in the wilderness on a gravel road like this. We're not gonna be able to make it to the town. It's 30 minutes till it gets dark. So we're just gonna pitch a tent somewhere. Maybe pitch our hammocks, something like that. We don't have really any food, just a couple granola bars. We just got a little bit of water, but not too much. So nobody knows where we are. So let's do this. So this is what we got going for us right here. Basically gravel roads for the next 10 miles or however how long we have, and the sun's setting.
It might be a great sunset tonight. It looks like it.
Okay, you have to check out these Mammatus clouds right now, man. These are awesome. Ethan Rutterow, I'm thinking of you. Man.
This is beautiful.
Sun's almost set. We have a spot maybe off the beaten path a little bit. Hey, what do you think of this spot?
I am loving it.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Look at this. We could even set up our hammocks if we wanted to. Maybe. Might be difficult, but why do that when you got a tent? This is what we currently see. So, obviously, it's getting late. Getting really dark now. Okay, Nate, you almost done, bro?
Nope.
Just been standing here for the past 15 minutes waiting on you.
I am a slow guy. Slow-moving guy.
It's pretty dark now. You can see Venus right there. You can't really see inside this tent. 10:30, and tomorrow's a new day.
And I'm ready to sleep.
We're going
to
be about halfway to Barcelona, in between Valencia and Barcelona. Good night.
The beaten path.
Our way up to the castle and we got our tickets to go in.
€5.
Yeah, it was only €5. Guess it's pretty cool that Game of Thrones was filmed here.
Never seen it.
Yeah, I haven't either. It's pretty humid outside. What do you think, Nate?
It's pretty humid.
Yeah. And we've been, like, super hungry. And so we've been paddling, trying to find the right place. And so we're just out of it. We're gonna try this Indian place. I don't know what you're doing right now, but enjoy the air-conditioned room that you are most likely sitting in. Oh, yeah! Nate, why do you look so confused? Well, here's the campsite. We cycled in the middle of nowhere, as you can see, clearly. I guess this isn't what Google made it seem to be, unless we keep going down and this actually isn't the spot. But the beach is right behind us and it might be a beautiful coastline, so we might go check that out too. So we just asked around and found out that this spot right over here actually has possible tent arrangements, and we have the beach right over here. So we're gonna go in and see if they have rooms, let alone
plenty of tents in there, or places to put tents. It's just a question of how much.
Yeah. So we're actually in a different spot, and Nate's in there right now talking, so you can clearly see him, and we're trying to figure out exactly what to do because things are just getting stressful, I guess, at this time of day, because we don't want to spend too much money at all, because it's $20 for a night, and they're charging for the bikes, too, which, I mean, if you think about it, yeah, people do that, but, like, why?
Actually, I'll explain what's happening. So we obviously came to this place, and Nate went inside to talk, and they said it was going to cost us 20 euros to spend the night here. I mean, it's a campsite. It's in a great location. And we tried to talk it down. We thought they said we could do 16, but it ended up being only 19. What's even worse is that Nathan's spoke actually broke again on his bike. And we're nowhere near anything. We actually cycled 20 miles away from any populated area that could have a bike shop. I'm gonna probably go to the beach, take a shower, and get a drink and some Wi-Fi. It is day number 30 here in Spain. And boy, oh boy, has the last 6 or so hours have been kind of just meh. But anyways, today we're going to be traveling to Tarragona, Spain. And the weather is gorgeous. I mean, do you see this? Like, this is awesome. Let's check in on Nate.
Yeah, so I don't really know. He told me that he would check over everything, but then he went ahead and just replaced the one spoke. Didn't change the wheel. So I'm okay
but
with
it's,
that.
It's okay for now. We'll see what happens. Pray that it doesn't break again, but chances are it can easily. But we'll see what happens. Just gonna send it. Nathan and I have just spent approximately the last 2 hours or so here at this McDonald's, simply just using the Wi-Fi for things that are important, okay, people? It's important. We've gone about 55 miles today, and we're gonna cycle another 11 miles to go to a campsite past Tarragona. So,
do it.
Yeah, we're gonna do it. I'm just gonna listen to the entire La La Land soundtrack, and that's going to be our
time frame.
Type thing. Yeah. So, let's get to it. We made that in like 30 minutes. The La La Land soundtrack isn't even on the last song yet. Bet you've never seen a guy look so good in your life. While Nathan goes inside to check out the camp stuff, it's time to do something. Wow. 1,400 miles Nathan and I have traveled just between Portugal and Spain, but still most of it has been done by bicycle, and
And I feel like I haven't done a whole lot, but I've done so much more than I thought I'd physically be capable of doing. I hope you can hear me well, because I have my camera covered in a cloth right now to block from the wind, because I know you guys hate that, and there's a lot of that in my videos. Sorry, I can't actually take that out because I don't have a mic that does that. But either way, I am just outside of Tarragona, Spain, about 50 miles as the crow flies from Barcelona, and that's where chapter 4 is going to take off from. The treacherous, exhausting, invigorating cycling climb up to Andorra in the Pyrenees. It's going to be probably one of the hardest things I've ever done in my entire life. My leg is completely healed up. Today we cycled 64 miles. Guys, go out there, be different. Just commit. Do something crazy. Do something you never thought you'd be able to do. Drop out of college. I'm kidding, don't do that. So? I don't think I forgot anything. See you, chapter 4.